flashy, everything classy. Come to the Air Zip and get flashy.
Air Zip, Air Zip. Air Zip, Air Zip. Na na na, yeah. Air Zip, Air Zip.
Yes, hello. I do it my way. I do it my way. Yes, welcome, welcome. My name is Maurice, the Crochet Master, and I'd like to welcome you guys. Welcome to my YouTube channel. And if it's your first time to be on this channel, please just make it a point and click on that red button so that you can ring that bell. Because I be uploading videos every Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So it's the that's how we always do it here at on our channel. So my name is Maurice the Crochet Master, and I go by the names of Maurice the Crochet Master. That is my personal account on Instagram. And still you can follow Hair Zipper on Twitter, Hair Zipper on Instagram, Hair Zipper on Facebook. So today we are going to see something that is very, very different. To those ones who have been following all my videos that I be uploading, there is the previous videos I was showing you how to do the natural tango. That was like last year, and this time around, since we are in this new year, I decided to make a little change so that you can see more creativity about the style. So if you didn't know how we always start the natural tango, I would like you to see here very properly so that you can also learn that we divide this into three portions, and then we start doing it like threes from down. Yes, because we all know that kinky, sometimes it is very it is hard like to play it. So you have to use some method that are going to be protective to some hair type like the 4C. So that's why we always started with 3. So you just play it some quarter inch like, and then you tie there so that you come and start the twisting. This time around the twisting is going to change. It's not going to be like the way we always do the twisting, because this one we call it natural tango. So it's just going to be like we are just tangling some the piece, the kinky. So I would like you to see it very, very clearly so that you get to learn all this. Yes, I will always tell you this, that please, whenever you're trying to do these things, make sure that you line your boxes very neat, because at the end of it all, it is going to give you the good results. So it is very, very important to always to do the lining very, very neat, just like the way you're saying. You might choose to do the box, or sometimes you use a triangular, in case you just do it the way you feel. So and those ones who would like to do this kind of if you like to use this method, I would always advise that please try to count like the way you'd be at this side here, like the way you had said me doing the front, the behind, then the front. When you reach in the front, that the kinky that we always use, sometimes it is different at the volume, just because you find that in the middle the hair is firm enough than these ones on the sides, because the side hair is always weak. And so if you try to use the kinky, like maybe you have put the bigger volume, it might bring the damage the hair. So you just have to count it, and that's why sometimes we don't overpack kinky, because I already see some guys you overpack the kinky. You know, when we overpack, that means we have to hold little hair, and then you find you have put the little hair, you're holding the little hair, you're putting the big hair, the bigger volume of kinky, then that means that hair is not going to be firm enough to hold that long braid for that long, that you're going to stay with that hair. So it should always be very, very protective when you just make it spaced, not very spaced, but at least you make them look simple, feel on the head, so that it doesn't make you uncomfortable. Because sometimes it's when the times when it is a lot on your head and you won't even it won't be comfortable for you at times of sleeping, and then you find yourself you're trying to stretch it, so that one brings the damage on your hairline. That's why people keep on complaining that kinky breaks their hair, but it's just because of that. Sometimes we do overpack it, and yet it is not good. Maybe you can overpack it when you're going to use a small volume of the kinky than like these ones that I've done. So today's trick is that we're going to try to get our curls. Because if you try to watch these previous videos that I uploaded last time, there are those tricks that I'll be showing you when we're doing the twisting. So that this video I would like to show you how you can get these curls even when you don't have the palm rods. Yes, so we're just going to divide our twist like this, and you remember sometimes you just have to hold the same volume so that your curls can look equal. You understand what I'm saying? And shout out to everyone who is watching me wherever you are. If you're in Jamaica, those ones in London, United States of America, those ones in German, Oman, United Emirates. Yes, just know I love you so much, and I can't forget my people in Africa, Kenya, Nairobi, Uganda, the Pearl of Africa. Thank you so much for loving Kezipa. Thank you so much for loving Morris, the Crochet Master. So this is how I'm going to try to do it this way. And then remember, when we do this, after, you know what is next. We just have to dip the hair into water. And this is how we can get. This one is somehow very risky. So you just have to be very careful whenever you're trying to do it, because you may end up burning someone. So you just have to be very, very careful. So when you apply this hot water, it doesn't take long, because what I like about it, even a person's not supposed to be in the dryer. It's just a matter of removing the braid from the water, and then you just unplate it. Then the water is done, like it's dry from the hair, because this is kink, remember, so it can't stay with water for long. So this is how you can do it. You see how we're trying to be very careful so that we don't burn our client, and this is how we still do it. Yes, I like friends, I like sharing ideas, and those ones who would like to go to my personal account, that is Maurice the Crochet Master. This other one is just for the company, and that is Hair Zipper. You can go for more pictures so that you can see all those different types of hairstyle for kids. Yes, they're all there. And now this is how it is. So we have to unplate what we had dipped in our hot water so that we see the results, how it's going to be. So you just have to do it slowly by slowly, as you can see. Yes, the person's not supposed to go in the kinky, in the dryer already, because it will be dry. Yes, be dry already. So you just have to remove it this way, just like that. You can see the way I spaced my kinky. That one, I just know that it is, my hair is protective already, it cannot break it a lot. So you guys, those ones who think that kinky is painful or kinky breaks hair, it's not right. It's just a matter of how you plait it. Me, I believe like all hairstyles can break hair, but the problem is how do you plait it? How are you trying to, because we have got a different types of hair type. So it depends on how you're trying to plait it. So for today's case, this is our natural tongue and this is how it looks. So try it on, because I told you, whenever you see something, you better try it out, because that one will make you be perfect all the time. You just have to see something and then you make sure that you try it all the time. Yes, you see and you try it. So this is our natural tango, and please, if you didn't watch our previous videos, they are very massive. They will give you more interest about this hair, and you will pick it, you will just love it, because the way it is very, very nice. This is how it is, and I'm gonna sign out. My name is Maurice the Crochet Master. See you in my next video, and please don't forget to subscribe. Bye-bye.